Today we're going to talk about absolute value. And absolute value means the distance from zero. So it's really measuring a distance. We write the absolute value with these things called absolute value bars. And notice, let's say I take the absolute value of 3. Notice that the absolute value bars go both higher or above the number 3 and below the number 3. That way you can tell them apart from the number 1. And how far from 0 is 3? Well, that's pretty simple. It is 3 units away from 0. And we can do absolute value of negative numbers also. Like, how far is the negative 3 from 0? Well, it is also 3 units from 0. So the absolute value of negative 3 is 3. Now remember, since it's a distance, and a distance is never a negative number, but it can be 0. And the way it is 0 is if you have the absolute value of 0, that is 0 away from 0. And that's actually the only number whose value is not a positive number. Remember, 0 is neither negative nor positive. And so all the absolute values are either positive or 0, because you cannot have a negative value as an absolute value. Now, don't confuse that. You can have the absolute value of a negative number, but you cannot have the absolute value being equal to a negative number. It will never be equal to a negative number. The absolute value bars also do act like a grouping symbol, just like parentheses. If I had 3 plus 2 in parentheses, and then I said I wanted to multiply that by 5, I would do my grouping symbol first, 3 plus 2, and I would get 5 times 5. Well, similarly, and then of course we'd get 25, similarly, I can use absolute value bars as a grouping symbol. So if I say 2 times the absolute value of 5 plus 3, then I do my absolute value grouping symbol first, but this time I actually have to keep the absolute value bars there. And so I say that that is 2 times the absolute value of whatever 5 plus 3 is. Well, now 5 plus 3 is 8, and so we write it this way. And now that there's no more arithmetic to do inside the absolute value bars, then you take away the sign if you want, or you find the distance away from 0, and so you get 2 times 8, which is 16. So remember, the absolute value bars also act as a grouping symbol. Remember, first do the operation or the arithmetic inside, and then take away the sign when you take away the absolute value bars. So if I have, for example, 5 minus absolute value of negative 3 plus 5. Now, right now, it's not important if you don't know what negative 3 plus 5 is. I'll tell you that that answer is 2. That answer is 2. Absolute value of negative 3 plus 5 is 2. And so we do that entire grouping symbol first. So we do the negative 3 plus 5 first before we take away the absolute value bars. And so we get 5 minus the absolute value of 2. And now we take away the absolute value bars, and the absolute value of 2 is 2, because 2 is 2 units away from 0. And now we can do the rest of it, and 5 minus 2 is 3. Here's another example. 7 minus absolute value of negative 4 plus negative 1. Now, again, for now, it's okay if you don't know what negative 4 plus negative 1 is. I'm going to tell you that negative 4 plus negative 1 is negative 5. But we haven't gotten rid of the absolute value bars yet. And so we need to keep those there. So now we have 7 minus absolute value of negative 5. And absolute value of negative 5 is 5. That gets rid of the absolute value bars. We've applied them or used them up. And we have 7 minus 5. And 7 minus 5 is 2. So be real careful about that. Do the absolute value in after you evaluate the inside part. Do all the math, the arithmetic, inside the absolute value bars before you apply the absolute value bars. And then just remember that absolute value means the distance away from zero. Thank you.